everybody, and welcome back. So it is the season of hearts everywhere, and I'm not a huge heart person. I like the shape, but I'm not a fan of like Valentine's Day and pinks and reds everywhere. It gets a little obnoxious to me. So what we're gonna do today is do a Howlite Heart, because I figured, you know, you guys are going to have hearts and lots of them to color, so why not do a fun and different way to color them in? And let's turn them into stones. Howlite is actually a white stone, white, light gray-ish stone, and then it has gray, light gray, dark gray, black cracks in it. And I figured to make this really, really interesting, it would be fun to do that. I'm only going to be using two grays to make this super, super simple for us. I'm using my polychromos, which, as you know, are my favorite. I've got cold gray 3 and cold gray 5. So just two different grays, a light gray and a dark gray, to do this with. And what we're going to do first is, I've already got a little bit of a shadow around the edge just because I wanted to for no other reason than that. But we're going to go in here and we're going to echo this heart and change it into what kind of looks much more like a button gem, because stone is opaque, it's not translucent. So we're going to do it like this, so that it looks like it's got the sides beveled and then the top's flat, if you understand that, what that means. So if I'm understanding what that means, from the side it would kind of look like this. That's what we're trying to do, make it look like that. Okay, so it's the light's hitting it from here and it's opaque, and we're gonna do veins all over it to make it look cool. So we're going to have this here and this here, whereas on a flat gem it would look like this and like that. On a button gem, one of the faceted button gems that I've done, it would look more like that. So we're basically doing that, but with the heart shape. And since we don't, everything else is a curve, we only have those lines here and here. So we gotta figure out where our light is coming from, which I think should be up here. And so this is gonna be our lightest spot up here. We're gonna have a little bit of darker parts up here. We're going to kind of shade this in a little bit, because remember, this is a quote-unquote white stone. Whenever anything is actually white, it's not really white. It's actually just different shades of gray. I'm thinking that I actually might want to get a lighter gray, but this will work to show you guys. I might want to get cold gray 2 or something. And then if the light's hitting here, then we're going to have a shine going on. So we're going to work around over here. Go a little bit darker with it. We don't want to lose our line as we work away from there. And of course, you could do this with colors very, very easily if you wanted to do it with color instead of gray. I'm just doing with it in gray because that's what I wanted to do. Because I was kind of looking for the stone look. So, and then of course, if our light's sitting over here, then this is going to be almost in complete shadow. So we're going to go ahead and run the gray over here as well. Then come back and make it darker. If the light's hitting here, then it's also going to be hitting over here. Because light from a light source comes out at an angle. So it'll also hit over here, which means this will be a little bit darker. So it's that. All right. So that's our basic shading, as you can see. So we've got kind of that little bit of 3D effect going on. This could definitely be a lot smoother, for sure. Alright, so let's grab our darker pencil. I'm going to get this a nice clean edge over here. Nice clean edge over here. Since this is the farthest away from our light source, we want to go a little bit darker with the gray over here. And of course, you could go as dark as you'd like. Get some black in here if you wanted it to be black. There we go. That's looking pretty good. This, again, would be really, really dark on this side of it. And let's bring that up a little bit. Alright, so now that we've got kind of a 3D effect going on here, I'm going to bring a little bit more gray right here. Make sure your pencil is nice and sharp, and you can just begin going in with those veins, the cracks and stuff in your howlite. Now, when you get up here, never continue the same line in the same direction. You want it to break off as soon as it changes onto the flat top. So if it's coming this way, we're going to break it off this way. And same over here. And just do some of these really cool looking little cracks. You can go super light with it. You can go super dark with it. Up to you. And of course, if you wanted to use like a yellow and a red, you could do it like that. And it would still look pretty awesome. I just kind of wanted to go with that stone look, like I said, with the howlite. So and you can do super, super cracked out veins and cracks everywhere. You can do it with just some of them. I just thought this was a different way to do some of these hearts and give them a little bit more character. It's super simple, you know. I'm just using two pencils. And I'll be doing more just heart stuff and coloring them as gems and whatnot in different ways while we're in this heart-a-thon of going into February. So, there's my little Howlite heart. Definitely go in and use warm grays, dark grays, cool grays. You can use blues. You could use any kind of color you really, really want to. And it would look absolutely fabulous. It does not have to be gray unless you're really just going for a howlite look or a grayed out heart. So, I hope you enjoyed this. And I hope you do your own. And I hope that you show me. So, let me know how yours goes. I'll talk to you next time. Bye.